The past days I have been working on siren circuits. The inspiration came from this book of 1980, say an electronic yearbook, and there was this circuit. I made it, but it didn't work. It worked a little bit, but I found there was no, say, good timing in this circuit, so that sometimes I heard a kind of siren sound, and on another moment it wasn't there. So unstable, but anyway, I have to say, I try to make it not with an AD149, that's a germanium transistor, but I made it with a 2N3055, and that's a silicon transistor. So I think it has to do with that, and I also had the loudspeaker box in the collector lead. Anyway, it worked a little bit. So I went on with my experiments and found this circuit. It took a very, very long time to make. I had not expected that at all. Anyway, the first circuit, experimental circuit, is here. And you can make it, it surely works. The good thing is that it has a 2N3055 directly connected to the circuit, directly wired in, but I found that it worked a little bit critical. It did not want to work between, say, 3 volts and, say, 20 volts. And my idea was to publish a circuit that could work in this complete broad frequency range, voltage range. So this was the next circuit, and this works in a very broad voltage range. In fact, it's the same as the earlier circuit, compared to the earlier circuit, but I use a third transistor, not a power transistor, but a small NPN silicon transistor, the BC547, and well, it has some features, and I want to demonstrate that. I have a new oscilloscope, by the way, this one, a digital oscilloscope, because I wanted to do more experiments on higher frequencies, and this scope had in the data sheet that it could work to 200 megahertz. I'm not going to demonstrate that now. In the afternoon I tested it somewhat and it worked properly on 70 megahertz, but at the moment I don't have a sine wave oscillator that goes to 200 megahertz, so there will perhaps be a review. But anyway, the circuit again, and this is how it was made. Of course, looks very sloppy, but took many hours to find it out, and I'm gonna demonstrate it now. This new scope has a fan in it, so perhaps you hear that fan on the background, and that's the reason why I started without this scope on. Voltage supply is 3.7 volts. Signal tracer is also connected, and here you hear the sound. It's quite unpleasant to hear on the background, but anyway, I want to demonstrate at first the effect of the voltage. Now we go from 3.7 volts to 20 volts. And we look at the scope. at the same time 3.7 volts. volts. I have to do something to bring the to correct the scope. 7.8, 13.3, 3. Again a correction. Of course it's not real time due to the fact that this is a digital scope, etc. 26 volts. I go back now to the, say, the circuit and the voltage where I wanted to make it for. That's 12 volts. And gonna turn out the potentiometers. There's one potentiometer here in the circuit. It's here. That sets the bias of the second transistor. And there's one potentiometer here that goes from the collector to the base of the third transistor. And you can omit it and use a wire here. But I wired in a potentiometer to show the properties of the circuit. The say the sweep or the sound can be changed substantially, and also with this one anyway. Want to demonstrate that? And now set the bias of the first transistor. On 12 volt. Let's see what happens when we go to 3 volts. This is 3 volts. I have to adapt the scope. I don't think I can get the line again now within a short time in the middle of the screen, but anyway, go to 12 volt again. Now I want to demonstrate the, say, the connection from the first transistor here to the third transistor, and that's here in the circuit, this potentiometer, and the effect of that potentiometer. I lift up the volume of the signal tracer now. Anyway, it was more or less all to tell. One thing to tell is this: when you change the value of this capacitor, the sweep gets also more slow. So now it's just 220 microfarad. When you make it higher, the sweep gets slower. That's of course logic. It's a time-dependent circuit. The capacitor needs more time to charge and discharge because the capacitance is much bigger anyway. So let's see, let's look at that effect, and I have by purpose here made a switch to show that. Now I switch in the higher value capacitor. Now I turn the potentiometer that connects the first stage from the oscillator to the second stage, the value. And now the working point, the bias. So I switch off everything now. I don't like the fan of this scope. Perhaps I will switch it off, make a switch to switch it off. Anyway, I have to say, at first sight, this is a very, very good oscilloscope. My first ID. Again, the circuit. Well, there's nothing more to tell. The good thing is that it can work from 3 volts or 3.5 volts up to 24 volts. And I'm working on another circuit to drive a loudspeaker, to make this a kind of alarm circuit for 12 volt for automotive or a car application. That will take some time. The first experiment is there, but not very successful. Perhaps I have to use a field effect, a power field effect transistor. Anyway. This looks very sloppy, by the way. But I'm absolutely sure that this is a good circuit and you can use it in all kinds of practical applications.